The descendants of some 6,000 original Indian workers who settled in Kenya upon the completion of the railway are rarely acknowledged. With the mission accomplished, part of the workforce settled in Kenya, later to become the first lot of migrant professionals. The human sacrifice for the railway was much greater. Over 38 Indian workers died every month during the 6 years of the completion of the railway. At the end, 2,493 Indian workers had shed their blood in the construction of the railway.
There, some of them went to the small trades like shops on the main stations from Mombasa to Kisumu, wherever there was a sizable population. They built this little shop, the Indian style, with a canopy in front, 2-3 rooms at the back. And they started trading in small requirements of the local community.
It's always been a sort of a misrepresentation that Indians which you found in East Africa came to build the railway. Of course they did. There were over 35,000 Indians came from India, brought by the British administration.
A sizable influx of Indians to Kenya was triggered by the construction of the railway line. The British administration brought in over 30,000 indentured labourers known as coolies on contract to construct the Mombasa-Kisumu line from 1886 to 1901. They had a mammoth task to accomplish along the 931-kilometre Kenya-Uganda railway track on an unknown and wild terrain.
There were four Indians that died for every mile of line laid. If that happened in this day and age, there would be a complete outcry. They didn't have shoes. I mean, can you imagine walking through the Savo without shoes?
Once the railway was complete in 1902, about 26,000 labourers and artisans were given passage back to their home.
Quite a few of the workers lost their lives to wildlife, like the man-eaters of Savo and so on, and a lot of pestilence. There was a lot of diseases like malaria and tsetse fly, which was sleeping sickness, which took a huge toll on the workers.
The railway workers left a lasting legacy in Kenya's history. The Indian population in Kenya too has been growing. From about 12,000 in 1911, the Indian population grew to 98,000 and, at the time of Kenya's independence in 1963, rose to 177,000. It drastically dropped a decade later to 78,000 after Kenya's independence. Among the prominent descendants were Bhajan Singh Bhamra. At 80 years of age, Bhajan Singh remembers his childhood days next to the train stations. At the age of 16, Bhajan Singh was a fitter in the train. This skill was passed on from his father, who came in 1908 and was a train driver. And after a few years of repairing the train and putting coal, he eventually took on his father's shoes.
The train will get stuck. There was a lot of rain and wildlife. Herds of elephants that will interrupt our journey.
What kind of people did you work with?
We all mixed, Muslims, things. We used to work as brothers. So. Very nice people.
The Indian laborers succeeded in building the 1,200-foot Salisbury Bridge, today known as Kibarani, that joins the Mombasa Island to the mainland. They built 35 viaducts in the Rift Valley and 1,280 smaller bridges and culverts.
We were paid £2 a month, £2 sterling per month as stipend. This was a contract. It was not slavery. We were paid. But we were actually regimented under the British Raj.
Indian families found a place in modern Kenya and over the past 200 years have been involved in all sectors of the economy. The building of the railway also captures that labour and not only trade are the basis of Asian-African settlement. Asian Africans enjoy a bicontinental tradition where they hold the culture of the Indian Ocean of their Asian ancestors but are deeply rooted in their African home.
We have fought for the independence of Kenya, and it is recorded, it is accepted, and there's no doubt about it. Our loyalty is absolute.
The story of Harbhajan Singh is just one example of a legacy that remains part of a Kenyan history. But household names such as Piyogama Pinto, A.M. Jeevanji and Markhan Singh are family names who remain engraved in Kenya's history, as they all played a national role model for all Kenyans. Anjali Gadvi Nurani for Celebrating Kenya at 50.